one blind, who has become blind by the wish of poison of what? Vishamishka. Those people who are always steeped in sensuous indulgence only. The last time we saw Khao Bivo, Majaka Rupa. That's what is the goal of life. These people, you see, AK2, to be contrast to the Vrishti, Vishvrishtiyo, Pramanovai, Vrishtiyo, as told by Sanatsujatiya, in contrast, these people say, Ataha Anyam, other than this Vrishtiyo, other than Vishvrishtiyo, other than this Vrishtiyo, what is that? Actually, Pramana. Pramana called as Vrishtiyo, that is Ajnana, Pramana called as Vrishtiyo, other than that, Ataha Anyam. So, whom they say, the one Yama, wheel of fascination. Amrutam. Amrutam. Why is Amrutam? Because Amarana Dharma, this Yamaraja, you know who is? He is Amrutam. Amarana Dharma. Why is Amarana Dharma? You know who is this? He is a Brahmanya. Brahmanyami and Dharma. So therefore, he has restored himself to be the one who is free from destruction, death. So that is Amara Dharma. Brahmacharyam. The one who is in the Brahmacharya. Brahmacharya is not a Sanskrit word here. Brahmacharya is Brahmani Svatmabhuti Charati. Means Brahmanishtam. The one who is Brahmanishtam. Not only one can go out of knowledge of oneself, but always mind is absorbed in the Brahma Sarupa, that is this one Sarupa, that is Brahmacharya, with the Jnani, that you can know how to promote it with the Guru. The Brahma is the Guru, the Tikita is the disciple. But that Brahmacharya, that Brahmacharya is Brahma Nishtha. So Brahmacharya, so Brahmacharya, Yama, Nidra, Yama, Atma Vatam, Atma Vatam. The one who is abiding in Atma, that is Antakara. He is made of Manusruti. He is Atmani. Here means Buddhav in the Buddhi. So, Vasati is Atma. Yamanaka is meant to abide that in Antakara. It means Yamanaka is nothing but manifestation of Paramatma in terms of execution of law. Nothing but Paramatma only. The one who punishes the jiva in accordance with the karma phala. So therefore, so Yama is manifestation of Paramatma only as a presiding deity. As a presiding deity, who is called as Dandakarta Paramatma. Paramatma who punishes. Punishes how? According to the law of karma. Therefore, this Paramatma manifests Dandakarta, the one who executes the law of karma and they are punished accordingly. So that's why he is called as this that for the Manusruti is one certificate for the one is Atma Vatam. Mrutyam Ahuhu. They call him as the Mrutyu. And Yaha, this Mrutyu, that is what does he do? That is he. He says Yaha, Yaha, Deva, deciding deity. So where does they go? Which kingdom does they go? Vitruloke Rajyam Anushan. So he rules the kingdom called Vitruloke. Yamaloka also is called as Vitruloke. You have heard the word Yamaloka. The word is also called as Vitruloka. So he is the one who rules that kingdom of Vitruloka. So Vitruloke Rajyam Anushasi. Tata so also, Yaha this Vrutti, you know who is? Shiva, Shiva Nam, Shiva. Shiva Nam means Punya Karma Nam. Those who take to Punya, meritoriously, for them he is what? Shiva means Sukha Pradaha. This Yamaraja is the one who bestows joy on those who have earned the Punya. Ashivana means Papa Karmana, those who indulge in sinful deeds, he is what? Ashiva, Shivami, a Sukha Prajaha, one who gives the punishment, one who gives the sorrow. Realistically, Yamaraja has neither favor nor disfavor. He is not obliging someone or he is not punishing. All get punished because of their own laws of karma. For example, so when a Supreme Court judge may restore the property of someone, and to other person he may give a capital punishment. How does he do to them? As per the law of the country. So likewise, Maharaja executes the law. He is not that he is partial to someone and children to others, not that way at all. So Shiva, those who take to Punya Karma, for them he is one who gives joy and to do. So, this is located in Raja, but that's Yamaraja is there. Now, say Yamaraja is there or not? Is he called Bhukti or not? And you see there is no other Bhukti. So, what else is there now?
Yes.
Maybe. But if you understood, so it is not going to tell us. That Bhukti is there, but this Bhukti is secondary, not primary. Is not primary because this Yamaraja executes the law. What are you asking? He writes on Bokel. Bokel stands for Papa Tikara. You are ignorant of yourself. As a result, you are identified with the embodiment. And you would not know your Swarupa. Swarupa, you desire to and if possible, you have what you do, you take to karma. Karma means you are bound by the karma, that's part of it. And what? Not that you stick to dharma only, sir. Sticking to dharma is literally not possible. Even dharma raja, right, or some one or two defects are found in even dharma raja. So, part of it. And then, normal person takes to more power than the punya, sir. But even if a person is very careful about taking to punya, it is not totally possible. So, papa punya karma, janma marma continues. And body of nature, is the body going to be permanently there? You know? Who, Hiranyakashipu, is the tapas is invoking who? Brahman. And that is finally Brahmaji revealed himself. So Brahmaji then was asked, what you want? What is the food you want? He said, I want Amruta. Immortality. How immortality? With the body. He said, sorry, I also can't tell you. Even who? Brahmaji or Hiranyagarbha cannot be immortal living at body. He may be living for a very long period of time compared to the rest of the beings, but he also has to shed the body one day. So, wielding the body, immortality, and Amrutatva is just not possible. Then, whenever people thought that he is a very clever person, and you know what he is, not for a good, that he should not be killed by anything, etc. And good was granted, and he was killed by finding out the loopholes in the night of the day, not the night, I should be killed. So he was killed at the time of death. Neither inside the house nor outside the house, on the sky. Neither on the ground nor in the sky, on the land. Neither by man nor by animal, nor by deva, asura, devata, nara, deva. Not by any weapons. Law. The right see, one also got legal department. The legal department. Bhavan also, he asked the security from all, but he overlooked one person. See that. Man, he overlooked. What man can do to me and who kill him? Man only kill him. Like this. If the body immortality is not possible, then it is. So, because of ajnana, you you are wearing the body, and because you are wearing the body, you come under the jurisdiction of who? Yamaraja. Now, who is the, this is the primary discipline. Yamaraja, Kanyana, that's what it is there. The last time we have seen, in the primary discipline, the Murti also means the cause of destruction, disaster. Asyana is the cause of disaster. It is very clearly told in the Kino, the Vyasya last time. If you gain the knowledge here right now, well done. If you don't get Mahati Vinashti, it means Adhyana is nothing but philosopher destruction. So that means Adhyana is the primary Yudhya. Also in Dhritarashtra it is said, Yudhya Vai Tamaha Yodhi Amrutam. Yudhyurvai tamaha. Tamaha, it has got Yudhyur. Yodhi amutam. Yodhi here stands for Prakasha Rupa Jnana. Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana, which is, that is what amutam imhatanti. So that is the case. The cause of all anuttas, all disasters and sorrows is what? Nothing but Jnana. So, Yamaraja has gift you with a secondary primary is not Adhyana. Number one, then Lord Krishna also has said the same thing. Adhyane namutam jnanam dinam vihyanti jantama. So jnana is covered by what? Adhyana. That's what people get subjected to. Sorrow comes from God. So that means again, though Yamaraja is available as a secondary virtue, primary virtue is Pramada. Adhyana called Pramada. Pramada is the primary virtue. Now the question is, how does it operate? What is the modus operandi of this Adhyana? Very interesting. How this Adhyana becomes the cause of bondage to Kama, Krodha,
First, let us say two meanings. What is that? It means
ahankara, adhiman. One meaning. Other meaning, apya as the kama vihara vidishina. But let us say, apya, apya means Asyatmana in the form of Asya, Parinamati, Nishtarati, means manifest, it manifests. What is this Asya? Abhimana, that is Ahankar, the notion of shyness in the embodiment. Taking the body at the trial, I, so that is what is the notion of shyness in the embodiment, that is what ahankara is asya. First, it manifests in the form of ahankara. Then, tataha, kamaha, then it becomes the desire to have this and that. So, please, ignorance manifests then ahankara, notion of kindness in the body, and ahankara further gets modified in terms of vidhāya kāma, vidhāya kāma, vishtarati. Then, kāma, so the desire, whatever, in course of time, because of some obstruction or non-fulfillment, gets modified in terms of growth, anger, or it can be frustration, depression, whatever it may be, that can be there. So why? Because desire is not fulfilled. So, desire is not fulfilled. So, that is krodha. So, krodha. So, krodha. So, and then further, pramada. You know in Bhagavad Gita, what is it? Jayato vishyam pūsaha sandhasti subhyam samapra vishyayana yurtukam. Because of it, the desire is being born. Sangat Sanjayate Kama. Kama Krodha Vijayate. That means it has modified itself in terms of Krodha. And as a result, what happens? Pramadaha. This Pramada is not the earlier Pramada or called Ajnana. Here it is. It is mistake and judgment. An angry person, what does he do himself or herself? He doesn't. Guru Mati Bhiktaro. One may let me thought, inside even the elderly people, one should not do that. Afterward, one may what is it? You can tell you, I should not have that. When the person gets angry, the person is no more than person. Remember? So, that is pramada, that is state, which means that they take to wrong judgment, mistaken judgment. Or mistaken judgment, pramada. This is the pramada, is not the jnana, because from jnana we have started. Then further, moha rupashya, moha rupashya, vidya jnana, bhanti, erroneous notion about everything, including oneself. In Sandhapur we have seen moha rupa and vidya jnana. So moha rupashya, so then, ahankatena eva vimargācharan. Because of this, we have got lots of desire. And desire need to be fulfilled. And for fulfillment of desire, what is that? The person is ready to do anything he wants. Even ready to violate the laws of God. Ahankatena eva, means by this ajnana, which has modified itself as ahankara, vimargācharan, taking to vimarga, vimarga means prohibited thing, shuddhi, and shuddhi, whatever that is told, that is vihita, enjoined by the shuddhi and shuddhi. So this person takes to those things which are prohibited by the shuddhi and shuddhi, vimargācharan. What happens? Atmanaha kinchit yogam naca upayeti. Doesn't get any yoga about Atmanaha. What is the yoga here? Abidance of the mind in the Atmanaha. mind, when the mind wants to move, mind is absorbed, totally absorbed in the vision. That step by step, how it is absorbed, and because of it, one is not able to appreciate what Sarupa will be described afterwards, step by step. Number Yogam. Yogam here, that is the absorption in the Sarupa. The mind abides in the Sarupa. That is it. And Paramatma Yoga. Bhaskara says, Samadhi Lakshana. The mind which is absorbed in the Sarupa, this person is not able to get. All because of what? Ajnana. Ajnana gives rise to Ahankara, against his body. Thereby, Kama. After Kama, modified in terms of Krodha. Then Pramada wrong decision, Bhanti, and in this manner, due to Ahankara, so finally it makes the means which are prohibited by the Shastra and Sarvadrasa, and then the next part of the web of Samsara, mind is not able to get absorbed in the Sarupa, that is what is Pramada way. So here we have taken the meaning of Asya as the Ahankara or Abhimana identity with the body. Other way of speaking Asya as Kama. Literally, so Asya means Dukha. Mouth is for Asya. So Asya means where you throw something. What do you do? The body means give life. Always something or other, going on the list of eating, ask, throw. At times, so some, that is loka sarsarkal ask, because sarva dharakavkar kakarukar, by karmakara, the kalosa throws them. So that is jiva, that take appointment, literally, figuratively, as if they are thrown them. So now other way of speaking that other thing, this ajnana manifests itself as dharma desire directly specific. How it can be taken that way? So that is for that answer in this language. See, from Vedanta this much is known. What is the samsara going? The perfect of Sanatsujatiya. This whatever we have exposed so far to Vedanta, what is the samsara going? There are three more things. Avidya, Kama, and even Avidya, Kama, Karma, Kala, Udaya, Vrati. This must be my difference. Avidya, Kama, Karma. Avidya, Kanda, food, moha as vrutti, moha, vrutti, sammataha. In that context, so pravāno vai vrutti means ajnana, avidya. Avidya means what? Non-cognition of, non-apprehension of one's own svarūpa as a avidya vajitya. Then, dhāni, moha as a, what is it? Disapprehension of agrahana, anyata agrahana, mandukya previous, mandukya karika previous. Agrahana, non-apprehension of one's own sarupa as a bit more pramado and gusyo, ajnana or pandava to come back to. Then, moha, bhanti, that is anyata agrahana, erroneous notion about what that, nabhisapprehension of one says, these two, agrahana, anyatha agrahana, means ignorance of oneself and misapprehension of oneself. Both are the same, but avidya only in the memory of my thought. This was pointed out as the cause of samsara in Shanta. In Shanta 9, karmodaye asatva, the karma and the cause of bondage will be described later. What is that called now? Avidya, Kama, Karma, Akama. Kama is that this art here can be by whisper the genealogy can be taken as पश्यन्ते शुद्यन्ते अनेन संसारे प्राणिनः इति आशयः कामः पश्यन्ते निक्षिप्यन्ते सो दैट माय विच जीवाः आर थ्रोन इन्टु संसार व्हाट इज इट दैट इज काम व्हाट इज इट When we die, that can a person remember to die, be quiet. What does it take to karma? Karma means what is inevitable? Karma means what is inevitable? Janma marana, janma marana, you see. Sansara, maneka, all a part of all. Because of karma,
being part
caught up in this left part of my head.
Devohita tattva sevartamana.
Devohita tattva sevartamana.
Ita kreta tattva punaspatanti.
Ita kreta tattva punaspatanti.
Lower embodiment, I least here he will enjoy some joy at the kind of work. But otherwise, from the beginning itself, we got more embodiment. And finally, it's the what is called Jayasra Priyasra. Jayasra Priyasra. We want to die. We want to die. Like the speaker character drama, when the monsoon arrives, so you have seen those flight, once the wind, whatever. that also died next about like Shankaracharya said, like nobody is business, no? Taking this one part, no? Take one rocket. Take another rocket. Like that.
By karma. So some people say, because soldiers,
So it is wrong in doing part of the karma day. When karma takes place, karma is purple. When the karma takes place, so when karma does not happen, what is going to happen? You do action, in terms of action, simple. Karma means karma phala. Good or bad, depending on what you can't see to care. Karma phala are always in accordance with the karma. You sow the seeds to eat and can you expect mango fruit? That's what? Individuals never can, when they say, do the karma. But when the results come, they blame who? Poor guy is there. So to sympathize with whom? They point that they actually do. That is what they don't know that they themselves are taken to such karma. Karma daye, karma phala is inevitable. And why did this person take to karma? To get the result. That's what happened. The raga, attachment, asakti about karma phala is bound to be karma for karma, karma daye, karma phala raga. Jiva, who have a total asakti, attachment to the karmaphala, whatever, tatra anuyanti, anuyanti, they follow the karmaphala, how? By taking to that embodiment, by taking that embodiment as the karmaphala. As a result, vrityu mataranti, they are unable to get free from mrityu, unable to get free from ajnana. So, why so? Because this is the reason. What happens? Say, evam tadarthya yoga navagama. Because of not being able to take to yoga of tadarthya. So what is yoga here? What is sadharma letter? The thing that is stuck. What is it? Paramatma Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa. So yoga, yoga means ekatva, ekarupa, identity with the Paramatma Swarupa, that is the Swarupa. Anavagama, without being able to know it, without being able to gain it. Being unable to have the ekarupatva identity with one's own swarupa. Why? You tell me one thing. How can jiva have identity with paramatma swarupa? Paramatma pakadu, jiva pakadu. And now that is the side of power. Or you have a higher tied up for Pakakira. Is it? Jiva has to discover my Swarupa as Paramatma Swarupa in contrast to mistake of motion in the body effect. Now tell me, this instrument in us, which aspect in us can do this job?
Antakar.
Which aspect in us can discover the our Swarupa as Paramatma who Antakar. Antakar means mind. So that's all. Mind must be able to take to discovery of. So that's all. Mind should be available to take to this discovery of. Now, what peculiarity of the mind is that? You know what is that? Mind is a musical chair. It can take once only a given thing. Presently, where it is occupied? How many given? What is it? Vishya of the chair. Can it finish? Is it ever possible that mind should take to yoga? No. That's all what? Of course, this person takes to yoga, you see, satisfaction is thanks to yoga, not with yoga, with yoga. Sadhartha yoga is not possible. With yoga is that, bhoga yoga, new yoga, new yoga. Karma yoga, jnana yoga, radha yoga. I got yoga. So I did yoga. Bhoga yoga. Not able to say to the Sadhartha yoga anapama. Anapama, not able to take the absorb of the mind, the sarupa, saman, dehi, what is that? Bhoga yoga, atma, from yoga, the bhanda yoga, bhoga yoga, intention center, samanta from all sides, from that. Pravartate, parigramati, get caught up in the Brahma, samsara, janma, marna, because of the after that, vishaya. So, if that is the case, is there a way out of that? Starting point is ajnana. But actual in practice, who doesn't have desire? Why you should have desire? Desire for what? Vishaya, is it not? Why you should have desire for Vishaya?
Incomplete.
Sala Sankosha, what is that
question?
Vishaya has got capacity to be with the joy that I want. Vishayas are permanent in nature and Vishayas are real. Is it not? Do you remember why the mind runs after the Vishaya? Mind runs after the Vishaya only when it is convinced of three things, three features of the Vishaya. Right here only, but when it has to get convinced of three features of Vishaya, do you know what happens? Satyatva, Nityatva, and Samichinatva. The Vishaya is Satya, real. Vishaya is Nitya, permanent. Vishaya is Samichina, has the capacity to give me the contentment and the joy that I want out of. When it is convinced of this exam, for the time being, its motion is that Vishayas are satya, real, they are nitya, permanent, they have got the capacity to give it up. If by this vivega, without taking the thing for granted, if it investigates and discovers Vishayas are not satya, they are not nitya. They don't have the capacity of giving me what I am expecting from them. Afterwards, no force in the world can ever drag the mind to the Vishaya. So the false nature of Vishaya has to be discovered. And such a person, what does he do? Turns away from the Vishaya, takes to Sadhartha Yoga. One who doesn't take to Bhoga Yoga. Tadvai maha mohana indriyaha.
Tadvai maha mohana indriyaha.
Nityatha yogesya tatvati nitya.
Nityatha yogesya tatvati nitya.
Nityatha yoga vihatantarasa.
Nityatha yoga vihatantarasa.
Narasnubhaste vishayasamanta.
Vaste Vishayam Samanta
Indriya Tadvai Mahamohana. He Hatya Vidya Kayogi Vadi Nitya. Atmayogi Vati Nishya. This is one way, of thinking on the other. Indriyana Tatvai Mahamohana Vidyatmayogi Asya Vati Hi Nishya. Second line. Vidyatmayoga Vihatantara Vishayana Smaran Vishaya Samanta Smaran Upasya Vidyata Yoga Vihatanta Rasma Vishaya Samanta Smaran Upasya.
परिपालयन्तां न्यायेन मार्गेण महीमहीशा गोब्राह्मणेभ्य शुभमस्तु नित्यं लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु काले वर्षतु पर्जन्यः इति विशेषशालिनी देशोऽयं शोभरहितः ब्राह्मणा सन्तु निर्दया ॐ सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखः भवेत् असतो मा सत्त्वमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा ॐ पूर्णमदः